Hey, welcome. Today we're gonna build this project, Flying Helicopter, with CSS3 animations. This project is part of my Complete CSS3 Animations course at Educative Institute. You can buy this text-only course from this platform if you wish to, or you can be a member of this platform and start learning right away. So, are you willing to build this project? Let's begin. Let's create a new file, index.html, and add a boilerplate. The title should be Flying Helicopter, and in the body. So let's start with class Helicopter in the main element, and inside this main element, I have to add 4D. So first one is cockpit, second one is tail, and third one is main, and the last one is rotor. So inside this rotator div, we have to add rotator class. Inside this rotator, we have to add 2 empty div. So this is the structure for our helicopter. In this section, we're gonna design our HTML structure to turn into a helicopter shape. So we have to create a new file, styles.css, and then add this file in the HTML, like this. Let's save, and now go to styles.css. Let's tile our HTML body first. So in our body, width 100%, height 100 bh, display flex, align item center, justify content center. Here is a challenge for you. I want you to implement a cockpit shape like this using our cockpit class. So go ahead and implement this shape. You'll see my solution next. So, position absolute, overflow hidden, jet index 1, width 195 pixel, height 195 pixel, border radius 100 pixel for top, 40 pixel for right, 50 pixel for bottom, and 50 pixel for left. And of course, we have background color, W42FD, just a random color I put it. I just experimented before recording. So let's see the results with live server. Here is the result. Now we have to add a glass here to make it realistic. So in our cockpit before, will be content empty string, position absolute, jet index 1, top minus 10 pixel, left minus 25 pixel, width 170 pixel, height 170 pixel, border radius 40 pixel, and background color 302E37. Go save. Let's see the result. So here's our glass, but it would be better if we can add reflection for this glass inside this cockpit. After web content empty string, position absolute, that index 1, top minus 60 pixel, left minus 60 pixel, width 170 pixel, height 170 pixel, border radius 40 pixel, background color black, and make it half transparent. Here is the result. So our cockpit shape challenge is completed here. Here is a challenge for you. I want you to implement a shape looks like a tail like this. So go ahead and implement this shape with our tail class. So let's add this tail, add this styles position absolute, top 50 pixel, left 150 pixel, transform origin, border top 10 pixel, solid transparent, border bottom 80 pixel, solid transparent, border left 350 pixel, solid, and add a color like 2FADD2, and border bottom right radius 10 pixel, and of course height 10 pixel. So this is our result. So our tail challenge is completed here. Here is a challenge for you. I want you to implement this shape, like this image, using our router class. So go ahead and implement this shape. You see my solution next. So in our router class, we have width 70 pixel, height 70 pixel, border radius 350 pixel, position absolute, top minus 360 pixel, left minus 200 pixel, dead index 2, and we have to add a background color A2 double line AB, opacity 0.12, overflow hidden. Here's the result. This looks like a real circle. We need to make it oval shape. So add this transform, scale Y 0.075. With this scale Y, our circle height will be smaller and will look like a real router. It's time to make a rotator shape. So we have to target the two empty div inside the router to make this router realistic. You'll see beautiful animation when we will apply fly animation in the next section. So we have to target the empty div inside this rotator class, position absolute, top 50%, left 50%, margin left minus 350 pixel, margin top minus 30 pixel, width 700 pixel, height 80 pixel, background color white, like FFF, and then we have to trigger fast child of this rotator. So rotator div and child the first one, transform rotate 0 degree. So it will trigger the first empty div, and the second will trigger it when we apply the end child with the 2. We need to add transform rotate 90 degree angle. Okay, here's the result. So our router challenge is completed here. In this section, we're going to implement flying capability using CSS animations. Up until now, we created our helicopter shape and design, but without animation, it won't fly. So let's give it flying power. Let's create a keyframe called bounce, and in 0% and 100%, transform should translate 0 pixel in the y-axis minus 50 pixel, and rotate minus 15 degree. And in the keyframes at 50%, web transform translate 0 pixel x-axis and 50 pixel along with y-axis, and rotate minus 10 degree along the x-axis. Now let's see the animation by adding these keyframes in our helicopter class. So animation name should be bounce, and the duration 5 seconds with infinite. Here is the result, but here's a problem. Our router isn't rotating, and that's why there's stillness here. So we have to rotate it. Let's add a new keyframes called fly, and in this keyframes, in this 0%, we have transformed rotate 0 degree, and in 100% keyframe, we have transformed rotate 360 degree. So it will rotate at 0 to 360 degree from 0 to 100% keyframes. Now let's add this rotate keyframes in our class called rotator. So in a rotator, we can add this animation fly with its name and duration 0.6 seconds. Infinite. Here's the result. That's better. Let's delete this translate. It was just for demonstration. And reboot back them. So it will be aligned in the center. Just if you're going in the center and so on. Now we can make it much better of this router, because this router sometimes may not be seems realistic. So we can target this rotator class. Then in this position absolute, width 700 pixel, height 700 pixel, border radius 350 pixel. Cut this animation from there and paste here. That's much better. Very cool, right? One last thing before I finish this video. I wanted to add a background image here and put this helicopter on the right side. So go ahead and implement the styles. So I will add background image here with URL and paste these links. I will put a link in the description. This is a GIF link. Here is the result. So you can see the image is duplicated here. So we need to set background repeat, not repeat. Now I want to take all the images as a container. Here is the result. Also, I want to take this background image in the middle. So I would say background position center. Now I want to put this helicopter in the right side. No margin here. So I will apply some stars in the helicopter class. So position absolute, right 500 pixel. I just experimented this value before recording. Here is the results. There is no margin in the right side. And of course, we need to disable this scrolling. So overflow hidden. Here is the result. Make sure to play around with the CSS value. You can use any other values or any other properties to make it much more stand out. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.